the pieces of the piano are spread all over the room. In this box I'm about to move, that's the keyboard. I pulled the keyboard out of the piano and transported it in our car. Inside the piano bench are the screws that'll hold on the three piano legs. And there's one extra screw that holds on the lyre. We chatted and decided it'd be better to have the piano in a different orientation once it's up. So we're going to work it back parallel to the banister there for the stairs. Time to unwrap this thing and put on some piano legs. The strings resonate with the sound. Nothing is keeping the strings from vibrating, so they just vibrate along with whatever collision there is. I had designed the height of that tilting mechanism for the height of my dolly. Uh-oh, now the whole piano and dolly is on top of a new dolly on the left. Well, it works out to a 5/8 inch difference. I decided to just go for it. The piano is not attached to the dolly. And so as I tip, now the piano is coming down as I expect. The dolly lifts up a little bit, watch the bottom right. The piano slips off the dolly, but that's fine. It's now on one leg, it's on the gizmo, and slightly on the dolly still. And it looks like it's pulling away from me toward the banister, and it's not. It wants to go down, just the problem is I've got a chair in the way. The piano is now resting on two legs and the gizmo. Finally, it dawned on me that I didn't need to keep using that jack. I could just ask my wife to scoot the right boards under when I went and lifted one corner at a time.
Interesting. I don't know what the problem is yet.